Answers wrong. still caught unawares by ghosts lurking in my nightmares that mark our revolution with ancient loneliness and ancient pain. The old scars and the old scars ache again. Yes, I'm happy now as I rest in your love. You bring me such comfort and such release. Still caught unawares by ghosts lurking in my nightmares that mark our revolution with ancient loneliness and ancient
Mama, Mama, what do you see when you look at my life, when you look at me? Can you hear what I'm trying to say, or can you just gaze in that blind, loving way? Mama, oh, what do you know about the way your baby child's learning to grow? Are you aware that my woman friends are filling my life with beginnings and ends? Oh, Mama, Mama.
Well, do you understand why I've not bound myself to a man? Is something buried in your old widow's mind that blesses my choice of our own kind? Oh, Mama, Mama.
Oh, my Mama, Mama, well, I know you know, but you couldn't survive if I told you so. dance and write some cryptic thank yous for giving me the space to find such safely unspecific things as my strength, my freedom, and my life.
A very significant song, because I don't think a song has ever been written on this particular subject before. And I think it's high time that somebody wrote a song about this woman, because this woman has had, I think, one of the most important roles in the molding of young women's minds of any group of women, except maybe the camp counselor. Let us not discount the importance of the camp counselor. However, there is one I think that surpasses even that. And that is The Gym Teacher. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Yes, The Gym Teacher. I hardly know what to say. I hardly know which gym teacher to pick to tell you about. Well, there was one, though. There was one who had a very special place in my heart. And she was my eighth grade gym teacher. Her name was Miss Berger. Miss Berger, are you there? Miss Berger. It still yet makes my heart go pitter-pat to think about Miss Berger. I was notorious in the school for my adoration for Miss Berger. But it was okay then because I was, you know, what are you in the eighth grade? You're 13, 14. It's a phase, you know? And so it's okay. I have to tell you a story that is a perfect example of my feelings for Miss Berger and the way everyone reacted to them. Miss Berger had to teach hygiene every 6 weeks, you know? They take you out of the, you know, off the court and into the classrooms and make you, you know, take hygiene, and nobody likes it. Miss Berger didn't like it. We didn't like it. But she used to get pretty excited about various aspects of hygiene. She had this baby blue ruler. Whenever she got real excited, she'd start whamming on the desk, you know, with this ruler. One day she was getting real worked up about something. And she went whomp on the desk, and I was sitting about two rows back. It was as close as I could get in the rush for front row seats. And she went wham, and half of that baby blue ruler went flying into the air and landed somewhere a few rows away on the floor. And without a moment's notice, I leapt up out of my seat and went crawling on arms and knees over to that ruler. And everybody's going... And just as I was reaching out to get it, Betsy Norfleet snatched it up and put it in her pocketbook. And she sold it to me the next day for $1.50. That's a true story. Could have gotten five. So anyway, here's this song about my gym teacher. It's called Ode to a Gym Teacher. Showed me being female meant you still could be strong. And though graduation meant that we had to part, she'll always be a player on the ball field of my heart. I wrote her name on my notepad and I inked it on my dress. And I etched it on my locker and I carved it on my desk. And I painted big red hearts with her initials on my books. And I never knew till later why I got those funny looks. She was a big tough woman, the first to come along, that showed me being female meant you still could be strong. And though graduation meant that we had she'll always be a player on the ball field of my heart. Well, in gym class, while the others talked of boys that they love, I'd be thinking of new aches and pains a teacher had to rub. And while other girls went to the prom, I languished by the phone, calling up and hanging up if I found out she was home. She was a big time woman, the first to come along, that showed me being female meant you still could be strong. And though graduation meant for her whistle and some daisies in the spring. Some suggestive poems for Christmas by Miss Edna Millay. And a lacy, lacy, lacy card for Valentine's Day. Unsigned, of course. She was a big time woman. Sticks to teacher like a leaf sticks to a tree. One girl who runs the errands and who chases all the balls. One girl who may grow up to be the gayest of all.
Knowing of change. touch your face.
I just came running. Well, we found that we had lots in common, like music, drinking, and talking dirty, warbling, chortling until dawn. Self-conscious friends
but sincere, making bad jokes about suntan and natural rhythm that we thought we'd invented. And we had a grand old time, freaking out our mothers, threatening to blatantly bring our new friend home. And over very long beers in very dark bars, we get kinda mushy and symbolic, holding up our hands side by side. We'd marvel at our contrast, sharing drunken dreams of a future when it would not matter. But in the corners of our hearts and our minds, I know we kept a tally of the telltale signs that showed that though my intentions seemed fine, I was still my friend's oppressor. And under the very white southern blaze, she told me of the boy she loved. And though she teased and teased and teased, I told her nothing. Roz and I had never touched, really. But then I never touched anyone, really. Then came our final day in the rich red August afternoon. And there we were just standing in my room, writhing in the silence apart. Then suddenly we ran into each other's arms, swaying, swooning in the fierce tenderness of a moment. Then suddenly I was possessed by the reflex of a lesson learned too well, an old lesson that touches blow your cover. Only touch the one you know to be your lover. And so I panicked, and I stiffened, and I jerked away. And in the aching fierceness of the moment, her very black eyes burned into mine, and I knew that that aborted embrace negated all we'd shared. But I was locked in silent shock, and she walked away forever. Oh, Rosalind, what kind of world is this that twists and tears our mightiest moment, that forces me to forsake our struggle for another left unspoken, that surely makes you see my act only as a last betrayal, that makes me assume that I was alone in the fear at being queer. Sings for me so deep, so fine. The colors of your life shimmer round my heart like a rainbow. Your sorrows, your loves.
loves have all been mine, and your laughter a warming echo.
But this night I feel so deep, so near. By those so busy checking all your papers, their senses grow cold, they never hear the music you thought they came for. And I am so sad, and I am so afraid for those who cannot hear the music you have made. And I want to hold you so near, so long. Your songs will span the walls like a rainbow, with colors that heal and make us strong, and your love is a knowing echo.
Weaker than the stone, but far, but be aware. Singing is fun. Here we are and we're loving as one. And we're feeling the answers growing more clear. So where do we go from here?
Here we are and the singing is fun. Here we are and we're loving as one. And we're feeling the answers growing more clear. So where do we go from here?
Yoo-hoo's eyes won't meet mine, because that man is kind. Though you think your part is right, do you wake up empty in the night? Do you wake up lonely in the
other's arms so warm. Now find that your love is torn by guilt and fear. Find comfort here. Are you looking for your home? Where is your home?
Don't you know that something's not right? If sisterhood comes too easy or too hard, happy in life, happy in love, staying inside all warm and snug, drawing the curtains against the sight of sisters.
Her job, see her being raped,
and you really think you're safe?
Where is her home? Where is your home?
Whoa.
in between your choices, shrinking from all of the voices of the devil and the deep blue sea.
And all guitar, I listen for my music. I wonder how you are, and I'm afraid of my freedom. But my running days are done, so I start to sit still in my moments, sitting through changes, sitting through pain.
Please, why is it so? restless with memories, restless with dreams. Wake up forgetting which state I was in. Can't hold my adjustments, can't hold out my hand. I'm just a holding on,
holding on
in this borderland.
Changed all of But woman, your touch is so new, so unexpected, yet so long in waiting, such celebration in loving you.
Southern home. the pain that I could have found anywhere.
seeing you again. Those old defenses fell. I love you and I wish you well. I wish you well, my darling. Though the road be scattered and torn, it's over. But you still find your way into my song, and all the lovers that I have known are holding me tonight, keeping me warm. I wish you well, my darling. Know where I am now, know what I've seen, and all the children that I have been. Need my arms to go around them, take them back in. I wish you well, my darling. Thank you.
Well, this is the portion of the program known as Meg Set. Oh, thanks. And this is for us all.
Is it worth the price we pay? All the lives we've lost along the way? Only answer I can see, it's got to be.
This little folk singer's heart has just died and gone to heaven, I'll tell you. This is an inspirational number. I don't know about you, but I have spent an incredible amount of energy in my life waiting for X to happen. You know, you can fill in the blank any way you like, but when this thing happens, everything's going to be okay. You know, like, if I didn't have to go to work in the morning, everything would be okay. If there was only peace on earth, then I could relax. If Betty Lou would only come back to me. I would be a totally fulfilled human being. Well, I learned this thing. Great wisdom through painful experience. It's an inside job. Don't you love that lesson? One of our favorite lessons, yes. So I wrote this song called Look Within.
Just to fall out of the blue. The revolution, for the president to have a spiritual transfusion. I'm looking for the Holy Ghost and for you to say you love me the most.
This was not in my plan. This was not what I had on hand or in the rules. Well, I thought my life was full, but now everything inside is shifted over just a mile or two to make room for you. My life was set on a tidy stage, room for my work, room for play, no room for change. But you marched through all my pride like a fool in a china shop, and you busted up the whole design. But I don't mind.
No, I don't mind.
So you got my attention. You got my attention. Why are you rolling up your sleeve? The way you're smiling, well, it's unnerving. But I'm ready for your radical surgery. Well, maybe tomorrow when I wake, I'll say there's been some mistake. I must have lost my mind. Then I'll go right to my desk and answer all of my mail, write a novel, save the world. But today you have got my attention. You got my sleep. The way you're smiling, well, it's unnerving.
year you've been here, but this is my first with you. Hard to believe there was all my life that I lived without you. Happy birthday to you. I just came to say I'm so glad that you're alive, and I mean to stay and stay, birthday through birthday, watching your beauty glow and your greatness grow, and coming to know my own. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. The love of your life has polished you clear and true. Mirror to see, I am born ever new, every moment with you. Happy birthday to you. I just came to say I'm so glad that you're alive, and I mean to stay and stay, birthday through birthday, watching your beauty glow and your greatness grow, and coming to know my own.
drinking her beer, raging at rejection and raging at the bomb, stoking her fury to keep herself warm. And her husband had left her children ashamed, taking her money, sneaking away. So she paid for her booze with the dues from her bed, and she wished herself invisible, she wished herself dead, till some kind of miracle shook her to the bone. She opened her window and she started back home. And she tells me, don't you worry, you can do it, don't despair. If it hurts, I've been through it, and I got to hear from there. She said she grew weary of fighting the flow, so she laid down her weapons, she let it all go. Now she's swimming with the current where it isn't so hard, and she says she's sitting solid in the arms of her God. But she don't mind my bleeding, or I'm foolish with fear, or my love is gone and left me, and I got to get